Skill-based matchmaking is a pretty tricky topic, I would say. It's something that is needed in video games. Don't get me wrong, you can't just have noobs getting completely stomped out every game they play. But there's a fine line to where it's too much, to where they have skill-based matchmaking turned on too high, to a point where casual matches are no longer casual, and every game turns into an absolute sweatfest. No, I get it. Like everybody always tells me, you know, you just want to smack noobs, JB. That's all you want to do. Not necessarily. I just want to be able to relax. When I play a video game, I play it to relax. Call of Duty isn't my full-time job. I don't sit here and play Call of Duty 10 hours a day. I have to go to work. I have to go to school. It's things I have to do. I play Call of Duty to relax. And that's what I cannot do in Modern Warfare. In Modern Warfare, the skill-based matchmaking is turned up to a point where every single match you play is over-the-top competitive, to a point where I completely ditch 6v6 and 10v10 now. I mostly just play Ground War because I'm so tired, so tired of the amount of sweat. Now, don't get me wrong, I can hold my own against sweats. I can usually manage to get a 2-plus KD every single game I play. So it's not like I'm getting my butt kicked. I'm holding my own. I'm donating the sauce. But I'm not having fun. Who's having fun sweating every game they play? There's a reason why league play and ranked were invented and put into these games. I don't know why they didn't put it in Call of Duty Modern Warfare. But it's a reason why these things exist. So if you want to sweat, you can move to those game modes. Now, league play usually does absolutely awful in Call of Duty games. It's not like Rainbow Six Siege, where it actually does matter. You know, casuals do play casual, and then the sweats do play ranked. They need to give you some incentive, some reason to want to play league play in Call of Duty. Maybe you get special rewards that people don't get if they don't play league play. Or maybe you get double XP if you play league play. Or more camos, or extra weapons. You know, you have to give people a reason to want to play your competitive side of Call of Duty. If you just toss in league play and say, yeah, go play league play, that's where you can sweat it out, and you don't have any reason to go play it, you don't have any reward for going to play it, nobody's going to play it, nobody's going to touch it. So first off, initially they need to bring league play or some type of ranked game mode into Modern Warfare to balance out the skill-based matchmaking, because casuals are completely broken right now in Modern Warfare. Skill-based matchmaking has gotten so bad to the point where the community is so outraged by this that this hashtag is trending, which I will put in my title as well. Why not? I think it started with Blame Truth, then I saw The Murder Show put it up as well. I'm going to put it on my video too. It's called hashtag remove skill-based matchmaking. This thing, it's true. Remove the skill-based matchmaking. We're done with it. We're absolutely tired of sweating every game. I think over half the people who play this game play it casually. And I understand, you gotta separate the sweats from the casuals. It does make sense. But seriously, man, you wanna verse me or put me up against identical versions of myself every single game I play? You see, for me personally, when I play, and I have a high KD, a 2 to 3 KD per game, but that's me playing casually. It's not my fault that I'm decent at the game, and I don't have to sweat my balls off to be good at it. That's not my fault, so why should I be penalized? Because other people who have the same KD as me are people who sweat their balls off, camping all game long, hunting for the nukes every single game. When I get these things, when I start streaking off, usually it starts off casually, and then when I go for the nuke, I get a little bit more aggressive, but I enjoy the game. I have fun. But because I'm decent at the game, because I have 10 plus years of experience in Call of Duty, and I could play this game casually and still play decent, that means I have to verse a bunch of people who are sweating their asses off, have 10 packs of deodorant in their closet, rags all around the room to dab all the sweat off their foreheads, and about 50 shirts so they can change out every 5 minutes that they're playing. I don't want to verse these weirdos. I just want to have fun. Honestly, by far the best way to fix skill-based matchmaking, by far the best way, is to bring back the server browser. Now, a lot of people probably don't even know what server browsers are unless you play Battlefield games. But for console players, you probably don't know what a server browser is if you only play Call of Duty, because in Call of Duty, the only people who had server browsers back in the day were PC players. So only the PC players really know about this. But console deserves it as well. Everybody deserves server browsers. And what server browsers do is allows you to join in on your own servers. You can find the exact server you want. You can find the exact maps you want. And if you don't like it, it's as easy as leaving and joining a new game. But you don't have to leave and join a new game, because these servers are either run by individuals, people who pay to have their servers up, or they're owned by people who are actually, you know, Activision. I think EA DICE does it as well. They run their own servers, the official DICE servers that you can join. So I guess they would call it official Activision servers for Call of Duty. I don't know. But regardless, the server browsers are much needed, because then there's no skill-based matchmaking involved. You join the game, you get put on a random team, and it shuffles every single game you play. Also, it allows you to pick the best servers for your connection. So instead of having it randomly find you a lobby like it does in Modern Warfare, because, you know, the skill-based matchmaking is so thick that every lobby, it forces me to find a lobby with like 90 to 100 ping just to find the optimal opponents for me to verse. Instead of that, you just go to the server browser, you look to see which server has the best ping, and you join it in on that game. It's amazing. Honestly, I don't know why they took out server browsers. I guess so they could stick with the skill-based matchmaking agenda? That's all I could really think of. Because these server browsers completely remove skill-based matchmaking. There's no such thing as skill-based matchmaking with the server browsers. Now, me personally, I've been playing a lot of World at War lately. Also some Call of Duty 4. I would show you that gameplay, but I actually just used all of my gameplay for a TSG upload, so hopefully you guys see that as well. So these are some pretty old clips right here. I haven't been playing that much Modern Warfare at all because I just can't stand this game right now anymore. I'm probably going to not play it until the next season. Who knows? But regardless, I've been playing a lot of World at War, and it's just amazing to see the difference of gameplay and quality of life between a game that has a server browser and a game that doesn't. Now, I won't even compare it to Modern Warfare. Let's go to Black Ops 2. Let's say Black Ops 2. You go to a game like Black Ops 2, and you compare it to a game like World at War. I hop on World at War, I find a game with the perfect ping, I join the game. Tons of people, there's sweats in the lobby, people are completely dominating, dropping dogs every 5 seconds, and saucing stuff up, and there's tons of noobs in the lobby as well. I actually joined one today where I was getting completely dominated. I was the only person on my team going positive, and it was like a 10v10, and the other team was just completely dominating my team. To a point where we're like, yo, this isn't even fair at this point, why are we doing this? And people are switching teams. We switched teams, the admins made sure it was fair, it was even, we made sure it was enough sweats on each team to make it fair enough noobs on each team to make it fair enough. We made the game work. We made it fun. I hop onto Black Ops 2, and it's a different story. There is no server browser, so I just have to search for lobbies and pray to God, keep my fingers crossed that I find good servers with good players and a nice mix. And even if I do find a server with good players and it's a decent lobby, you know, it's sweats on both teams, noobs on both teams, you can't ensure that it's going to be good, because when the next game starts, it's probably going to keep the exact same lobby, the exact same team. So if you do join a bad game, if you do join a game where they give you like 50 noobs on your team and it's all sweats on the other team, it's probably going to stay the exact same way the next game and the game after and the game after that. Me personally, I would really love to see a return of the server browser. It's just such a great way to have fun with your game. Be able to pick the lobbies you want, pick the teams that you want, play on the best ping, best servers that will give you the best connection. You know, Modern Warfare is just too random for me, and skill-based matchmaking in general, way too random. I mean, 1 second I'm in a server where I have great ping, and the next second I'm in a server where I have 100 ping. Why? It just doesn't make any sense. Why can't I just stay in the server that has good ping? Why can't I just stay there and enjoy that server? Why do you have to kick me after every single game? It's stupid. And I also love the fact that in server browsers, like I just said, it evens out the lobbies. You don't have to verse the same people every single time, and you don't have to have the same noobs on your team every single time. It'll bounce it out eventually. People will eventually get together, make good teams on both sides, and it'll be a fun match. It'll be an even, fair, fun match. And also for the people who are hosting the servers, it's awesome. You get to choose what maps you want to have in the rotation. You get to choose who's in the lobby. And also for hackers, which is also another amazing thing of server browsers, if there is an admin in your lobby, they can just kick the hacker, permaban them, and you'll never see them ever again. But if you're playing a game where there is no server browsers, that can't be done. There is no admins in the lobby that can boot that guy. You have to either deal with the hacker for the rest of the match or back out and find another lobby. There's no in-between for it. But please, guys, go down into the comment section and let me know how you all feel about skill-based matchmaking and also about the server browser idea that I just tossed out here. Did you guys play on PC back in the day with server browsers? Or do you maybe play Battlefield and you experience server browsers? And what's your opinion on them? Do you think they're better? Do you think that they're worse than how we have our matchmaking system right now? Personally, like I just said, I think that server browsers would easily fix the skill-based matchmaking. They would fix the uneven teams, and they would also fix the hackers. It would fix it all if you allowed people to run their own servers or even have your Activision official servers that are running as well. I just prefer being able to find the best connection lobbies. I like having the best ping that I can possibly get out of a lobby, and I like being able to pick the maps that I want to play. It's just so convenient and so nice to be able to have a browser and choose what I want to choose, instead of having Activision put their fingers and foil every single plan or every single lobby that I possibly find. Like, whose idea was it? Whose genius idea was it to kick you out of every game? It's so stupid. It's like you find a good lobby that you enjoy, and they kick you out of it just so they can reevaluate your skill-based matchmaking to put you in an even sweatier lobby that can't even guarantee that you'll have good connection. They don't base it off of connection. They just base it off of sweat. They could give two craps if you have 20 ping or 100 ping. The only thing they care about is how sweaty the lobby is. But if you guys enjoyed today's video, make sure you go ahead and leave a like. If you hate it, you could always dislike it. If you're brand new to this channel and you enjoyed what you heard today, make sure you go ahead and subscribe to this channel and hit that bell notification button. It helps get notified on all my recent uploads. Also, if you just want to chat with me or even see some behind-the-scenes clips, you can follow me over on Twitter, at JbowenDaMan. And also, if you just want to catch me live streaming, I do that over on Twitch, at JbowenDaMan as well. Thank you guys so much for checking out this video, and I'll see you on the next one. Peace out.